Everything, it's crazy. The lighting and all of that.
Yeah, the production side. All right, we going live, King. Yes, sir.
To this day. To this day.
Bang, bang.
To this day.
Peace to the family. Peace to you and yours. You are now rocking with the best. Yes. Yes, indeed.
To this day.
This is your host with the most, Brother Rich Phil. And I am joined by a special guest, my good brother, Knowledge to God, from Hip Hop Is Real and Kia Light Productions, the legend.
It's an honor.
This day.
Yes, sir, man.
To this day.
Indeed.
What's
peace.
What's up, world? How y'all doing out there?
All is well. The world is chilling right now. You know what I mean? And tonight we are joined by our special guest, the one and only Alkibalon the Don. He will be in the building, ladies and gentlemen. So with that being said, I just want to say it is the 1st of April. We ain't on no April Fool's type of time tonight. Tonight is going to be a very powerful show. Tonight is going to be a very serious show. Tonight is going to be a show that many people are going to benefit from, because this show is leading up to a very important date and a very important time. And that's in a few days, okay? And what I'm speaking about is the eclipse that's coming up on April the 8th. So many things are revolving around that date that we are going to be steadily in our bag from this point forward leading up to that actual date. The day before that, we'll be laying out a multi-tiered presentation featuring myself, Brother Rich Phil, our good brother Alkibalon 44, and also our special guest, Blue Pillar 44. All right? So Rich Phil 44, Alkibalon the Don 44, and Blue Pillar 44 presents to you
to this day
Vulture Culture. All right, and in the Vulture Culture presentation is going to be different lectures inside of that and whatnot. And man, oh man, I got a glimpse of what y'all got coming up, and I'm just here to let you know we are going to deliver a bona fide classic. To be honest with you, I mean, when you just look at everything that has occurred ever since the announcement was made about the Vulture Culture lecture, which was approximately a month and change ago, me and Alkibalon got on YouTube and we made the announcement. You know what I mean? We launched it. And
we good?
And then we made this announcement. And right after that, life just began lifing, you know. The great divine speaks through signs. That's something that I always say. And I always say that whenever we put a title out there, we just stand back and we let the great divine do what thou wilt. And we allow symbol literacy to really begin to take over. So if anybody's been paying attention, things have been accelerating ever since that announcement has been made. The emergence of Vulture Culture has become very apparent. There's literally a civil war that has taken place, coincidentally, but not exclusively, to the vultures, right? It could have been anybody else, because there's so many other people inside of this culture, but the split that literally went down the middle was between the vultures and the other side. And then you got new members on the vulture side that made that team look even more powerful. And then we began speaking about aesthetic nihilism, which was not just a look, but a mind state. Not just a mind state, but we zeroed and we targeted certain artists, and we was like, pay attention to this artist right here. You might not hear about this artist, but you're gonna hear about this artist. So ever since we started talking about Playboi Carti and the opium movement, that's all you've been listening, that's all you've been hearing about, and that's damn sure all you've been seeing. Hold on. How do I know these things?
To this day.
Who do I work for? Right? What level of A&R does Brother Rich Phil have inside of the industry that he's such a connoisseur that he's putting his finger on the pulse, right? I wasn't on a bandwagon. I wasn't hopping on to what Playboi Carti was out here doing. Y'all didn't even know that he was the wave. I came and I was like, look, he got the whole youth movement. And sound like I'm out of whack or I'm out of date, like how the youth tries to talk about things going on in the older generation, and sometimes they don't, they sound like they're out of whack. Like, what the hell is this kid talking about? Right? So we explained what aesthetic nihilism is. We got into the whole theory behind nihilism, and we showed you how hip-hop has morphed and formed into a nihilistic lifestyle or a culture for that matter, and what that actually means, right? And why you, and it begins to solve a lot of mysteries that people have as to why the culture is in a certain direction that is it, that it, it is in because of social engineering and because of certain artists that that bring about a certain type of worldview. This worldview gets incubated in the minds of a generation that has grown into millions upon millions now. This is a viable generation. This generation that grew up in a year, you know, the two, I don't know what they call that generation that was born, I call them the Y2K generation, the ones born 2000 and on, right? Now these are consumers. Now they have a huge market share, right? Now, corporations and all kind of people are trying to speak to them. They're trying to learn the data about what they like and what they don't like because they got a lot of money, a lot of influence, and they know how to use the internet, and they're tech savvy, and they're set to inherit trillions upon trillions of dollars and whatnot when the baby boomers make their transitions. So we're just showing you what the culture is on. And we're steering you in a direction to bring you a very high-level explanation as to what is taking place by bringing forward one of the premier scientists in this community, one of the premier metaphysicians in this community, a brother, by the way, who has been on this platform in particular and other platforms across the span of this quote-unquote, you know, of this community, in this ever so expansive network. And this brother has displayed what we would call celestial prophecy. Okay? Hold on. Celestial prophecy. Right? A sweet technique where the brother's able to speak on a certain color or algorithm, point it out, and then forecast what they call predictive programming. He'll be like, yo, the color is purple and the number is 45. Right after that, that's all you start seeing. How does he know these things? Right? We did four full-fledged lectures, four hours plus. Each one of them were more than 4 hours, right? We did it over the span of 2 years. The brother was feeding our network jewelry, okay? When you go back, and you look at and you listen and you watch those four presentations, you will see prophecy in real time. Because keep in mind, all of these are timestamped. And the brother is laying down prophecy after prophecy after prophecy after prophecy. He is forecasting everything that you're seeing taking place all the way up into the triple solar flares that we saw the other day. I'm going to show you by taking clips of these presentations, we're going to show and prove how he predicted that, right? So we bringing Al-Kibalon back on the platform. Not only are we bringing Al-Kibalon back,
to this day,
we've decided that this is so important. This date, April the 8th, is so important, and this time that we're in is so important. We were like, you know what? We're going to bring Blue Pillar as well on board. Because we got to stack the deck on this one right here. You know what I'm talking about? All of us have a lot of research that we need to share with y'all leading up to the 8th, right? On the 7th, we're going to drop this lecture. So leading up to the 8th, we know that we all have a lot of information. We've been doing a lot of research. And God damn it, life has been lifing. You know, every day is something new. Bridges are falling. There's about to be a sacrifice of 3 cows. That's going to take place in Israel. And if that happens, right, if that happens and it's slated to happen in the month of April, if that happens, that will be the beginning, not of World War III. No, that's too simple of a call. The beginning of what they call the Armageddon, okay? It was written. So we are witnessing biblical prophecy before our very own eyes. We are living in what they call the living book, right? The book of Eli. So it's important that we stay focused. So much is happening. So many people are getting pulled in so many different directions. We've been telling you since last year that this year is going to be a huge shit show. But all you got to do is ride on the Node-Alleged KTL Airlines. You know what I mean? Strap yourselves in and get on this space shuttle, because this Nebuchadnezzar is going to take you through the matrix and places where you need to go. So without any further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I want to bring our guest on for the evening. First, before I do that, good brother, knowledge to God, how's everything going in your world, man?
Man, listen, everything is wonderful. You know, I just had a new child born into this world. You know,
big up that.
To this day,
you're a legend.
To this day,
catching up to me, right? You at 3 now?
Yeah, three. You know, the magic number.
Magic number, y'all.
You feel me? So I'm blessed, and, you know, I'm steady working. I just hit 400,000 subscribers.
Hold on.
Let me work.
You feel me?
To this day.
Doing this damn thing.
To this day.
So I just been constantly working, staying focused, you know, doing the battle rap thing. But, you know, I spoke to you yesterday about, like, you know, like, man, I feel like my purpose has always been Key of Life Production.
That's right.
You know,
we made magic over there.
Giving that information. And, you know, like I said, I've been upgrading my system.
That's right.
It's about reinventing myself.
It's always henceforth, Rich Phil, I know exactly what you mean, good brother.
You know, I'm 10 years in the game.
That's right.
10 years in the game. So, like, I feel like it's time to do something different. Of course, still kind of do what I've been doing, but, like, I'm better. I'm wiser. I know more. So I'm
You've
excited.
Evolved. That's
exactly.
Right. It's time to scale.
And I'm not, I don't feel like I'm ready to quit enough. I feel like I'm reinvigorated.
That's
I'm excited
right.
again.
That's
and,
right.
And I'm ready to do something different and ready to tackle on something new. You know what I'm saying? So at this point, I'm just excited about life. I'm happy that we've been reconnecting.
That's right.
We got to really build at the event, the Diddy event.
At the Revolt World.
Revolt World.
Yeah, yeah, that's where
you
I got my
saying?
Towel.
So that, like, just like, to kind of see anything happening, like, it's like, it's so interesting.
Were you not forewarned?
Man. Yeah, yeah.
Were you not forewarned?
Of course. And you know what's funny? You was one of the first people that was like, man, he don't own this. Like, I was like, yo, yeah, you know, he own this shit. You're like, nah, he don't own this shit. This ain't his.
Nah.
He just working. He's just the face.
To this day.
Face.
Yeah, but not overall,
about.
To this day.
I'm doing wonderful, and I'm excited, man. Excited to be here, and excited to be here chopping it up with the people. And again, taking on this new information, learning about VR, learning about all the new things that are happening in the world. Because
that's
to
right.
me, this is never the end. It's just a new beginning. You know what I'm saying? So
that's right.
That fear shit is out the window. We're not scared of anything. We're ready to take on what's coming.
That means a lot coming from you. You know what I mean? And first and foremost, much, much kudos and much honor to your success for your platform. You know what I mean? You built that up out the mud. Shout out to Matt Boulay. You know what I mean?
Yes,
shout out to your whole team working very arduous. Over there at Hip Hop Is Real, putting in that pain and that work. Shout out to the whole battle rap community who has free surf, by the way. You know what I'm talking about? Free to wave, either way. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, going in the one swimmer, yeah. Y'all been keeping us entertained, the battle rap community. Shout out to ARP. Shout out to Smack. Shout out to all of the leagues. Shout out to all of the God tiers. Everybody that's been working, making classics and whatnot, you know, just handling their business. I just want to say honors because it was some real dark winters and real boring, non-entertaining weekends.
Yeah.
They were saved by viral moments, you know? So, you know, big ups to them for that.
No, I completely agree. Yeah, definitely. Shout out to the culture of battle rap. And like I said, I'm just excited to work, man. I'm not slowing down. It's only going to get crazier.
You're done, though, man.
Another 400,000 subscribers this year,
another
man.
Another 400. You know what I'm talking about? Another 400. Much abundance, much success. Big up your chest, man. You know what I mean? Big up your chest and keep multiplying. So with that being said, I want to bring in another one of our legends out here who has been achieving much success in their endeavors and whatnot. Without any further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I want to open up the line for our guest of the evening, our special guest for the evening, our good brother, Alkibalon, the Don. Alkibalon 44 in the building. Peace to the God.
Peace. shout out to you, Red. Shout out to Knowledge. With all the success that both of you guys have been portraying. It's an honor to be on the platform once again. You know, Red, we, you know, had some very prophetic revelations transpire within the last couple of years, you know, predicated on, you know, what we spoke about. You know, we put together some information, right. We saw and we conquered, you know, and the idea is for, that plays out to human affairs, but a lot of people may not be able to, you know, see it for what it is. So how we lay it out, you know, we give it a very cosmic, perspective, which gives people a broader way to be able to take in information and internalize what the ancestors always prophesied relative to mythology. So, you know, this is going to be another one in the books.
That's right.
April 7th, which is prior to, you know, the solar eclipse. A lot of information we're going to dive into relative to the eclipse. That's going to be exciting in and of itself. I've heard people talk about the solar eclipse. I've heard people, speculate on what it is and, you know, the importance of it. You know, but I'm here to tell you. The angle that I'm going to come at it with may be completely contrary to popular belief. So I'm very, very excited to deliver that information. And at the end of the day, it's a win for all of us. So, you know, when people can really get the science and be able to work their minds and build their temples in a way where we can, not only foresee what's to take place, but also understand what's taking place in front of us. We got 1 foot in front of the other and we're ahead of the game. So I'm excited to bring about another lecture. It's going to be another monumental one a day prior to a very important date. And, you know, this is going to be legendary. So, you know, I encourage the family to tap in, get your tickets ASAP. Of course, myself, Red, Blue, we've done our due diligence. We did the research. We did our homework. Last few lectures that we had a couple of years ago, 4 or 5 hours plus, just delivering insight after insight. We're bringing
Mad
visuals.
Jewels.
We're bringing the aesthetics. We're bringing the information. It's all relative. It's all relevant. And, you know, it's just going to be another legendary lecture. So I'm excited to bring about this information to the family.
Yes. You know something that I realized when I was going through our archives? I was going through the archives of the first lecture that we did, right? Because I put a bundle together of all four of the previous ones. So I was chopping the bundle up, and I pressed play on the first one, and come to find out, that we started out our first one on a solar eclipse.
This was back in 2021, bro. So it started out, right? It started out on a solar eclipse. And we're going to bookend it, right, on a solar eclipse. So they say it's not how you start the race, it's how you finish it, right? So theoretically, this whole thing is really just us doing a little bit of follow-up on what we already basically came and did. Because the work really has already been done. When you go and you watch the last four presentations, I promise you, I shit you not, the good brother is giving you all of the, is literally roadmaps. Why is it roadmaps? Because like he said, he's giving it up to you in a real cosmic type of way. And that way, the information is timeless. So when you revisit it, it's not time stamped. It's cosmic. So it's still feeding you and whatnot, because you easily could listen to it and apply it to everything that's taking place in the now, like right now. So you were way ahead of your time, and the information was so ahead of its time that it's applicable right now. So I just can imagine, if that's the case, what you're going to be doing with this information that you're bringing on the 7th, how far down the line is that going to be applicable to? You know what I'm talking about? Is it going to be 2026 or something when we catch up to that? But, you know, there's so much going on metaphysically, esoterically, and occult-wise around the world. One of the main things that I wanted to point out tonight, why the name of this show tonight is called Crossing the Bridge, is that there's been enormous bridge symbology, right, that I see occurring in the news media, right? One, of course, the most dominant bridge symbology is the Francis Scott Key Bridge collapsing in Baltimore, right, and the significance of that bridge. But after that, right, you saw they've shown on the news, I counted about 3 other bridge incidents. So I say to myself, it is of no coincidence that April the 8th is coming and the solar eclipse, okay, this Xing or this quote-unquote crossing across America, this is crossing the bridge. This is basically when once you cross a bridge that you can't come back from. The sacrifice of the 3 red heifers is a crossing of the bridge that you cannot come back from. So the symbology of what they showed with Hannibal, that Hannibal Barker, and the symbology of the Moors, General Tyreek going into the Iberian Peninsula and burning the ships, or what they say somebody burns their bridges and whatnot. I'm seeing that on all type of levels these days.
Mm.
So what are we preparing ourselves for leading up to April 8th when we cross over that bridge? I'll keep it on.
Yes, sir. So
it's interesting. You know, me and my lady were talking last night about a lot of symbology dealing with the ships. And it's interesting, shout out to the Moors. You know, mooring means, you know, waters. It means ship. And the ship is symbolic of the body.
Right.
So, you know, when I see a ship, I already denote that to the body, but the universe has an interesting way of delivering messages. And, you know, the ancestors were very particular when it came to language. And this is something that I'm going to hit on too, you know, during a lecture when it comes to linguistics. But through a level of symbology, you know, when you look at these ships, more specifically, you're speaking, you know, not only of the body itself, but the ship came in contact with a bridge. And, you know, the bridge, you know, runs synonymous with DNA. So, right. You know, when you look into microbiology and you look into something called bacteriophage that has the capacity to carry DNA, you know, you're looking at the capacity for DNA to insert itself inside the body and deliver information. Mm-hmm. So it delivers it in such a way where it inserts the information into the cytoplasm of the cell, more specifically, that holds memory. And when you then see articles coming out relative to them trying to tap into this invisible matter, you know, during a solar eclipse, these individuals understand the physics when it comes to, you know, solar eclipses. So this right. is why, for me, like I said, it's super duper important to not just speculate over these events and sensationalize them as if, you know, it's something outside of us. Like, there's something going on, and that's my goal. Juxtapose them with not only ourselves, but understand that this is super beneficial for us. And if that's the case, then we have to take action in order to adhere to the benefits that come with these type of celestial events. You know, so, you know, there's a lot of energy coming in and out of this, you know, solar eclipse. Yes. I've always referenced the solar eclipse as what you call a dielectric portal. And, you know, a portal deals with the level of acceleration. So it only makes sense, you know, why they would, you know, tap into the particle accelerator during these times, because you're dealing with an influx of energy that's coming through the portal, but not just energy. We're talking about something specific, yes. Relative to gas or a plasma. And, you know, the plasma makes up majority of the body, but in order for you to successfully make transition, you gotta be able to maintain that plasma through a specific level of velocity via that plasma successfully disengaging from the physical body to return back to the stars. So if we understand that the solar eclipse is a portal and we have souls coming back and forth through this portal,
right?
Then in essence, our ancestors are in the air. And I've always spoke about this etheric environment that we exist in, what our ancestors called the primordial waters of Noon. So during the lecture, and I don't want to give too much here, but during the lecture, you know, I'm going to speak candidly about the process of this ingesting through bacteriophage of this information that's coming through via the air, which is just going to set up a level of recombination via the DNA, because the DNA is on schedule for what we always call as a download or an upload. It's a signature that's already written within us. Again, we're living out a prophecy, but the idea is to see, for example, when you see ships and you see, you know, bridges, you have to understand that these are almost like the modern day hieroglyphs. But a lot of people take these events at face value and have lacked the capacity to decipher what's really being said.
Right.
This is all an internal process. So when we understand that the DNA has a signature in it that is predicated on a recombination via taking in information from the air, then again, when we see articles coming out talking about that they're probing this space during the solar eclipse, henceforth why they're coming out with the movie Ghostbusters, there's information in the air that we're privy to. But again, the idea is to fashion a body in a way where we can ingest this information and thus go through a process, you know, that you know, we take advantage of and we receive as information. But again, like, it's that's why you got to tap into the lecture. It's like, it's taking me everything to hold on to this information, but I really want people to understand that we got to begin to also understand how the body works. I spoke, you know, plenty of times, you know, in Kemet, the Dogons, you know, they understood specifically, you know, when you want to speak on the body, the internal body, and how it functions, their way of communicating that was through personifying certain things in the body through dramas, whether it was mythology, whether it was plays. So personifying, say, for example, the mitochondria, it'd give the student a better way to internalize the job of the mitochondria in the body. But when we overstand how the body works, and then we look outside of ourselves and see events taking place, you know, whether it's on CNN, you know, whether it's in your personal reality, we have to understand that there's an ordering taking place within the body, because the DNA has a signature in it that's referenced to a prophecy that's playing out in real time via the solar eclipse that we are scheduled for, to not only receive a download, but, you know, make a major transition within our individual lives. So, you know, yeah, it's a lot going on in the world, but I just want people to understand that all of this is predicated on prophetic revelations that have been delivered, you know, by your ancestors for eons. So it's just another notch in the belt. But the idea, again, is to understand what you're looking at, so that way you can participate in it.
Indeed.
Go ahead, Red.
Indeed. When I did a little bit of research out Cubalon, and I saw all of the different events that are occurring on April the 8th, it was unprecedented. Like, I don't think I've ever seen a rollout like this for a celestial event, right? You have the CERN, like you were just talking about, the Large Hadron Collider, the first day of it coming back online, coincidentally, right, happens to be April the 8th. You also have three rockets being fired in the direction of the sun. Coincidentally as well, on April the 8th. Now, across multiple states, including but not limited to Texas, Ohio, and Niagara Falls, the governors have already declared a state of emergency. They didn't wait. They already declared a state of emergency based off of the fact that they want to extract resources and take advantage of the just declaring martial law or state of emergency. Then you also have on April the 8th, the National Guard, right, telling residents of multiple states to report any suspicious activities, right, as it relates to the eclipse. So yeah. I'm like, and this is just, there's more, right? But that's just what we're just touching on. The exact name of the rocket, I have it in my research, but I don't have it in front of me at the very moment. However, the name itself is rather interesting.
It's super duper interesting, because, again, it aligns with what we've been speaking about with this prophecy. You know, the ship itself is called Apep, you know, and Apep, of course, was the dragon / snake deity in Kemet.
Yes.
That wanted to wreak havoc on the sun god Ra. But every time the sun god Ra won, you know, so this is interesting because, you know, I was doing my research as well, and come to find out that in Kemet specifically, how they view solar eclipses is, you know, by way of Apep, the darkness representing Apep right. Taking over the snake. Sun. So, you know, and it's on the walls. You can see it on the walls. So I just think it's interesting that they're now firing rockets in the name of Apep at the sun during the solar eclipse, which runs in conjunction to literally what's written on the walls in Kemet. You know, so then you got to ask yourself, like, you know, what is the reason they're firing the rockets for? Like, why are they trying to create a distraction? Or even a level of destruction via these rockets.
Right.
You know, what is it that they know about that we don't know about? You know, so, you know, again, this is just another opportunity to bear witness to prophetic revelations that are playing out, you know, in real time. And I just, you know, like I said, you know, when the lecture happens April 7th, you know, I'm going to really dive into that and be very specific, you know, on what APEP not only represents on a celestial level, but what APEP represents in the body. See, there's an as above, so below, you know, concept that is playing out. So, you know, we overstand, for example, who APEP is relative to the body, and then we see them firing rockets by the name of APEP at the sun, you know, we can put two and two together and we can, you know, insert ourselves in the mythology and play it out accordingly. You know, like right. I've always said, when you play out these prophecies, you adopt a certain archetypal energy, you know, relative to the ancestors. So your script is very important, but you know, you have to have the eyes to see, you know, and be able to decode what's playing out. And when you feel like that you have enough courage to step up to the plate and really not only go up on platforms and teach this information, but also play out this information in your personal reality. You know, like I've always said, 101 times, you know, supernatural doors start to open up for you. You know, so it's very telling. A lot is transpiring on April 8th, and you just got to ask the question, like, why? What is it that they know that we don't? You know, why is it that we can't look at the solar eclipse? That's very interesting to me. You know, they tell us that we can't look at the solar eclipse, but it's like, why? You know, it's just certain questions personally that I have that, you know, I don't settle with. You know, I do my due diligence and dive in and try to understand not only how the ancestors seen solar eclipse, but how does this correspond to what's taking place within the body? You know, right. So a lot is happening. A lot is happening on April 8th.
Right. Total agreeance. You know, a lot is happening. A lot has happened. And a lot will happen. You know, we in those days, man. We're in those days and times. Man, Knowledge, do you have any questions just based off of things that you see going on?
You know, when I saw the video that everybody saw, I look at a lot of things, like we all look at at everything, like the stories that are being given to us to talk about.
Right.
You know, like when I woke up and I saw, you know, the ship hit the bridge.
Right.
I said, okay. The first thing I'm thinking is like, oh, like, are we under some type of attack?
Right,
like,
there's
something going on. Then I'm like, okay, it's an accident. Then I hear the conspiracy theories. Then I'm like, okay, is this just another distraction? What else is really happening? Like, you know what I'm saying? So as far as the information I've gotten, you know, I'm seeing, you know, people saying it could have been bombs on the bridge. Things like that.
I saw some explosions, good brother.
Yeah. I mean, I looked, you know what I'm saying? Do bridges normally collapse that easily?
Right.
You know, then it brings you back to 9/11.
Yeah.
So all of these things just kind of like make me say, what's going on right now in our time and day? Like, you know, what is it that they want us to be paying attention to compared to what's really happening? We just seen, you know, the whole thing was about Ukraine last year.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's always something new. So now we're in the Diddy and the bridge collapsing. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And one thing I say to a lot of people, too, there's like two different worlds that are being lived. There's the world of non-social media.
Right,
the people
right.
who wake up and just live life.
Yes.
And then there's the social media world.
Which is a whole nother planet or plane of existence.
So I'm like, okay, if I'm tapped into this, this is what, you know, this is what the people who control social media and what goes viral and things like that want us to be paying attention to.
That is exactly what it is. I watched the episode of Higher Level Conversations, and there was the guest. The guest was dropping information and real pertinent information about digital surveillance.
Mm.
Right. And data mining, digital surveillance, and the surveillance economy.
And it was very, very eye-opening. You know what I'm talking about? Just to the point that on social media, based off of the fact that the algorithm is controlled, a reality could be created for you.
Exactly.
Just by putting you in a whole echo chamber.
Mm-hmm.
A reality could be curated for you because your perception is your reality.
100%.
Yeah, so power that media holds is so apparent these days. It hasn't been more apparent, but we're at an intersection where you can now control media,
mm-hmm.
and media is apparently controlling. Yes. You can control with media, and you have the opportunity to be a controller of media.
Let me give you a real life scenario, right?
Please do.
I have a group, like my team.
Yes.
I deal with people who's going through things on a regular basis. And the conversation I'm having is, you know, what are we feeding ourselves? So I told a lot of my guys on my team, like, yo, what are you, like, when you wake up, you go through your Instagram, what are you seeing?
Right.
What are you listening to? What are you feeding your mind, your body, your spirit, right?
Right.
And he's like, damn, you know, I'm seeing all these IG models. I'm seeing all these conversations, all this, you know, I'm inundated with all of the shit that's happening in the aspect
in
of
the world.
Like, yeah, in
that bubble.
Yeah, in this hip hop, you know what I'm saying?
Or that trauma cycle.
I'm watching battle rap, I'm watching this, I'm watching, you know what I'm saying? Jostling, fighting. So I said, yo, bro, this is what I had to do. Cause I'm like, I'm becoming like, I'm feeding so much into this, and somehow, without me probably even knowing, unconsciously.
Right.
Taking on some of this shit. So I'm like, yo, bro, you know what I had to do? I had to, like, literally start following these whole other things. Things that when I'm waking up on my Instagram, right. The first thing I'm seeing is work out 3 times a day, do this thing, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm like, I got to
change your algorithm and your echo chamber.
Because if I don't, my whole life is going to be this thing. And this is what I'm going to be influenced by and eating every day. So if I don't change this shit, it's telling me what books I need to read. So in all of that, within that same month, my whole life changed within that month.
Right.
Doing these things. So I'm like, damn. So the depression, the anxiety, all of these things that are happening to me is because I'm out here scrolling, looking at a bunch of bullshit.
It's the reason why Meta is being sued. It's the reason why Google is being taken to court and they're losing. It's being proven.
Mm-hmm.
I suggest everybody go and watch that interview and just take in everything that was being said and go and do your research, because children's minds are malleable.
Yes.
There's never been a time, okay? There's never been a time. So this is the first generation that we're beginning to see.
Man.
Right? The effects of what social media, and not just social media, we're talking social media 2.0. The algorithm. Right? The algorithm, the AI algorithm. Now it's machine learning and whatnot. This is not human beings pressing a button. That was 1.0. This is the 2.0. And the way that it targets is, you know, it's very, you know, it's there's biases, okay? There's a lot of biases. So they're keeping our children's minds and their realities and their quote-unquote world stuck on drill, popping pills, who to kill, who just got killed,
mm-hmm.
what cat they trying to kill.
Especially once your kids control and they know what they, like, if you give your kid above 10 years old the ability to go do what they want online,
right.
Their mind becomes something super different that you're dealing with. Like, because
they more.
I got babies, right? And, you know, the only thing I let them watch is, you know, educational programming. So for young ages, like, they're super advanced because this is all they watch every day, all day, nonstop.
That's right.
So I'm watching my daughter, my son, who's 2 years old. He's able to count to 100 at 2.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
I didn't have to really give it to him, but he's watching it so much.
That he's just picking it
up. That's it.
Facts. How we sounding on the audio, KTL audience? I just read the, y'all like, Red, fix the sound. I'm over here. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, I'm over here. Tell me how we doing on the audio.
To this day.
To this day.
So
to this day.
Big up to my sound engineer, y'all. Clap it up for my sound engineer, Haiti. He's been doing his damn thing. You know what I'm talking about? We've been dealing with some real high tech stuff, big dog cameras and things of that nature. And yeah, we making it happen. Akiba Lon, you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yes, God. Yes. And I want to know from you knowledge, you know, because you have a grip on the media. And like you said, you've learned over the years, and now you have the numbers to, you know, you have a whole nation. You have more than a nation, 400,000. Shit.
Man.
That's a nation state amongst nation states. You know what I mean? You got a continent right there.
I realized doing media.
Yes.
On the level that I do it on, as far as battle rap, hip hop.
Yes.
And how I have the ability to control perception and thought. Yes. How much responsibility I have every day. So indeed. When I look at my position, I said, damn, I wonder. And then what I deal with, dealing with artists, dealing with league owners, right. People who want to be seen and perceived a certain way.
Right.
Not allowing certain truths to come out.
Right.
And me being a curator of that and like, yo, people are going to feel some type of way. You can get threatened physically, emotionally, however.
Legally.
Yeah. So I look at it like on the highest level. I'm like, if, you know, people could come and do this with me, imagine on the highest level. So, of course, all media is, like, not all media, but there's, like, they're not going to allow certain media to talk and certain things to happen. So all the popularized media, I can understand how a lot of them are controlled and bought. Like, when we go to CNN, CNBC, right. All of that, then they're pushing the same narrative, the same thing.
They showed you.
It's the same thing, though.
It's a script.
If I go, like... I'll wake up one morning. When Diddy shit happened.
Yeah.
I scroll down, shade room, baller alert. Da da da. Like.
Or the, yeah, they all.
And then I look, you know, because I got people post on my channel. I look right. At Hip Hop Israel. I'm like, damn, we all following the same. Even now, without even having to be paid, it's just what controls the monetization.
Right.
People are following the money, things of that nature. So it's like, it's a major control game all across the board. Down to the lowest level.
It is, definitely. What are some of the solutions to get the control in our hands?
The solution is by being unafraid and unapologetic. Being willing to just step out and fall on whatever, like, be ready to die for whatever you believe in. That's really the solution. And right. And nobody wants to be broke and fucked up and unable to feed their family.
You don't have to, though. Let me share something with you.
Let's go.
It's impossible to be doing this work.
Mm-hmm.
This work at this level, at this point in the game. This is not 2013 when we was in Harlem outside doing videos in the streets and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
It's about 10 million people who've become, quote unquote, enlightened. And not just enlightened, people are actually living a lifestyle now. Do you remember in 2016 when we came down to Atlanta and did the Hip Hop Awards?
That was amazing, like a life-changing situation for me personally.
Shout out to my guy.
I met Mama Pill and all that. Went to the crib and all that. History.
You feel me? We opened up the doors.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? Brought the brother in and showed him the lifestyle, not just consciousness on YouTube, but what it was to live life. What it was to live righteous, what it was to live consciously. You know, the brother came down to the A, and it was an eye-opener for him. And moving forward now, nah, I don't agree with that, because at the end of the day, men lie, women lie, numbers don't.
Yeah.
You know, with 1,000 people who believe in you, right? Just 1,000 to start out with. Let's not talk about 100,000. Let's not talk about 1 million strong. What 1,000 people who believe in what you're doing, and then you could dedicate what it is that you're doing every day. You don't gotta punch in.
Yeah,
you could live it.
100%.
1,000. That's all you need.
Yeah. So I mean, I feel like, you know, more people just gotta continuously to learn. I feel like education is definitely important. Self education.
Yes.
Teaching yourself, learning from experience.
Yes.
You know, a lot of people are intellectual masturbators.
Intellectual masturbators.
They want to be the smartest motherfucker, but it won't take any of that information to build or do anything with it.
Right. So, boom. Exactly. So now, in this day and age where education has transferred itself to the cloud and it's digital. Children have tablets. Children are accustomed to homeschooling now. That is a thing. It went from being a trend to actually being a movement. So with the movement of homeschooling and with the advance of technology like the Meta glasses, right, which mm-hmm. are VR, Blue Pill goes live and he shows the people what that looks like, with the Meta Quest, right, the VR glasses that I display and whatnot, those are $300, right? Those are compatible damn near to the $3,500 Apple Vision Pros. So with this rise in VR, with tablets and with basically just websites, we now can teach the children unfiltered consciousness. We don't have to wait for a physical apparatus. They're willing to be taught right now.
Yeah.
The curriculums are ready right now. The teachers are ready to teach the parents and the children. So that right there is a revolution. We didn't have that like we have it now. We didn't have the resources that we have now, and definitely we didn't have the amount of numbers. And like I said before, with the amount of numbers, there's no excuse whatsoever that things should not be functioning the way that they should be functioning, which is in a upward scalable mobility.
Mm-hmm.
It should be scalable right now. It should be scaling. So there's some framework and some structure that needs to be put together, brother.
I forgot exactly where I heard this quote, but it was saying that, I don't know, probably Bloop said it to me or something like that. Or I seen somewhere it was like all these new children and all these kids being born, they're not going to do anything the old way anymore. So what's going to happen to the system when the thing that's been powering and been the money source for everything has completely changed? What are they going to try to do with the system? Because I know they already know it's coming. They built it. They already enhanced and said this is what's coming. So to me, that means they already have something in place to be ready for that in some sort. But what is it? What does it look like?
Well, all of the jobs are being disrupted by AI as we speak, right?
95 so, million by right, next right, year or something?
Right.
Check the audio one more time.
Yo. Mic check. 1, 2, 1, 2.
How we looking? How we looking?
Hey, Ray, can you hear me?
Yes, I'll keep it on.
Okay, good.
I want you to add on to what we're building on about this this new paradigm and teaching the children and being the solutionaries.
How we sounding? We good?
Yeah, we good. I tried to come in a couple of times, but I didn't know if y'all could hear me. But we good now.
Okay.
Yeah, so, you know, like Knowledge was saying at the beginning, you know, it's really about first and foremost, you know, when you get into media, having a level of compassion, you know, for the younger generation, because, you know, these kids are being exposed to now via social media and even adults. Like we said, we're dealing with algorithms. And, you know, the first thing that we're quick to do as soon as we wake up out of bed is to go on IG and begin scrolling, you know, which starts that subjective programming process. You see, and this is why they don't want us to understand the deep physics of reality itself, because the minute, you know, we start internalizing this information, you know, via, you know, our optic, you know, cortex and visual cortex, you know, we begin to assimilate a reality predicated on what we're taking in as an algorithm. You know, so our reality begins to switch based on the fact that we're buying into information that doesn't even serve us any purpose.
Hold on real quick. Alki Balan, hold on.
Yeah.
His audio is not being fed through the mic. They're just picking up the backdrop of his audio.
Oh, so they're saying he's
yeah,
he's not loud enough to them.
All right, what about now?
Say something, I'll keep it on.
Please, can you hear me?
Let's make sure the chat can hear him.
Let me know if y'all can hear me.
I was going to say, too, if not, just raise his volume because, you know, he can project louder, if anything.
Everything's clear on my end. you got y'all started to come in a little stagnant at the or static maybe like 5 minutes ago, but it's clear now.
Nah, they saying you picking up. They saying you sound like you in the background or the backdrop. I know exactly what they mean, because if you were coming through the audio, through the mic,
we would hear
you in our headphones. You wouldn't sound like that. So give me a minute. And pardon me out there in the audience. We're working on this audio right now. This is a very intricate production right here. We're in the studio, so, you know, it's a lot of buttons and a lot of plugs and a lot of stuff. Give us a minute. Respectfully. And they say our mics are static.
Yeah, I can hear the hissing in the back, so it's like something would have to go down. I'm not sure exactly what it is. Yo.
Somebody was saying that we good. All right, give us an audio check in the audience, if you don't mind. It's really y'all are gonna be the ones to tell us what's good. We good?
Yeah.
All right, so we should be good. We should be good. Microphone check.
Are we good now? Are we good now?
Let me work.
To this day.
Please let me work.
To this day.
Yeah, good. We good. I'll keep it on. Let me hear your audio.
You said it's still bugging.
Peace. Can you hear me come through?
Peace.
Am I coming through clear?
We out here.
Oh, can you hear me?
Moon, what's up? How we sounding?
Y'all are coming through clear on my end.
Low?
They're saying my sound or your sound is low?
Say good.
What's up? What's up? What's up? We good? We good?
We gooch. I'll keep it on. It's good, they say.
Okay, let's get it.
All right, let's cook, man. Let's get back to it.
Yeah, so, you know, basically what I was saying was, you know, pretty much, you know, at the advent of being exposed to social media at a rapid pace, you know, the type of information with the algorithms that we're diving into,
yes,
the minute we get up, you know, we all got a habit of waking up and immediately going to IG and scrolling. But what I was saying was, you know, this is why they don't want us to understand the deeper physics of our reality, because, you know, our eyes take in 12 frames per second, which gives us the illusion of movement. But imagine then if those frames are sped up. And when those frames are sped up, we're taking in more and more information. But see, we're the observer of the reality outside of us. So we collapse the wave based on the type of information that we bring in. So we begin to then create a simulation based on the type of information that we're taking in. It's not even conducive for our well-being. And we start to begin to wonder why things may be undesirable in our, you know, experience, or, you know, we may be going through certain things that, you know, we never would have guessed we could have went through. But, you know, in my opinion, I honestly feel like, you know, with us having a symbiotic relationship to the planets, to the stars, you know, I'm like, you know, that's the real technically like body or celestial, you know, entities that have the ability to, you know, and I don't want to say control per se, but, you know, we hold dominion over the celestial world. So if we're engaging in social media to the extent where we're creating algorithms in our own personal reality, when we know that we have this cosmic celestial origin, it's like, who is dominating our reality at the end of the day? So we just got to, you know, begin to take heed again and understand that when we get into media and we want to feed these kids, you know, information, it has to be very strategic and very specific. You know, like Knowledge said, you know, the minute you go on social media today, like literally right now, you know, whether it's Shade Room or, you know, Baller Alert, all you're being exposed to is the information about, you know, whether it's Diddy or whether it's, you know, Kendrick beefing with, you know, Drake and, you know, but it may not even be something that we're interested into, but now it's like we're almost forced to like buy into things that,
would you saying that
we technically wouldn't even be really interested in.
Look how what just happened with Diddy. The kids and everybody out there has adopted No Diddy. Like, seriously, like, that literally just happened a couple, like, days ago. Everybody went from saying no homo, whatever, pause, to No Diddy is the new word. Like, they put everybody on notice. No Diddy is the new word. So we're all saying, like, my nigga, I did an interview for the first time, like, a day after it happened. And the dude said it like it was, like, natural. He said something, yeah, No Diddy.
Got onboarded right there.
So if that little bit of shit right there can happen like that, what else are they just, boom, next thing you know, we all, you know what I mean?
Everybody see, that's what I'm saying. See, and again, whatever
is on it.
Like, I'll keep it. And again, with social. If we don't control the algorithm, we don't control our reality. If we don't control the media, we don't control our reality. We don't control our perception. If we're not the one programming our day when we rise, if we don't have architects getting up at 3 a.m. putting together what our scroll is going to look like, what our quote-unquote storyline and what the energy is going to be like, and giving us the type of food that we need, because keep in mind, we eat through our eyes, we eat through our ears, we eat through our mouth as well.
Mm-hmm.
And you are what you eat.
That's true. And like we were saying, you know, the minute, you know, No Diddy goes on notice, like, everybody is saying it within a couple of hours. And I remember the times, you know, where, you know, say like music videos.
More volume.
Is more volume?
No, on our mic. I'm speaking to the engineer.
Cutting through clear. So what I was saying was basically, I remember, you know, those days when I was younger where, you know, if we wanted to see our favorite artists or, you know, we wanted to watch our favorite music video, like, we would have to literally know the time on a specific channel when that video was going to drop, or we had to, you know, keep the radio on for a certain amount of time in order to catch that song that came on. And then once you heard it, you didn't know when you were going to hear it again. See, I was back when YouTube wasn't really even a thing. So it wasn't something where I can just jump on YouTube and hear my favorite song over and over and over, or, you know, watch my favorite show over and over and over. It was a level of mystique, you know, that came with media back then, because we weren't privy again to, you know, being spoiled to where we could just stream, you know, whatever movie, whatever, you know, song, you know. Again, I was back when, you know, you had posters hanging on your wall.
Right.
You know, it was a reality where you had to use a lot of your imagination. And with that, it made these people look like they were 10 feet tall. But now we know what every celebrity, what every influencer is doing day by day. And for me, that like takes away, you know, the value of, you know, the culture that we call celebrity, if that's really even a thing. But, you know, it leaves us open and susceptible to, you know, again, information that is completely compromising to our well-being. It's like we don't even have the capacity to choose anymore. If we're disciplined enough, we can make a choice. But if we have this illusion of freedom as if these choices is all that we're given, and we lockstep into that specific algorithm, then that's where we stay. But, you know, like we were speaking on, the idea is to now create and build our own media and control it, and dictate what's being presented to the public. And like I said, it's not necessarily the media per se that's the bad guy. It's the issuers or the ones who are pushing the information through the media. But, you know, I just feel like it's just a thing where we have to begin to literally take control of the algorithm and understand that, you know, the idea is that they want us to present a reality that's conducive for them. They have to hijack the minds of us as the consumers And as we then live day to day, we're projecting information out into this, you know, what we call simulation, and building a reality that is sustainable for the individuals that don't have our, you know, best interests at heart. So, yeah, it's all about just taking control and building up our own platforms and media.
And I'm not going to lie, I hope you guys are able to hear me and everything is sounding good right now. But I was going to add, as much as, you know, we want to control the media and things like that as well, is more even about controlling this money, because a lot of that is what's controlling everything else. Max. So it's like the algorithm itself is not all that shit means is the money, really, so realistically.
Where the bread is going.
Yeah, the algorithm is like, yo, if you're not talking about this and you're talking about that, you ain't getting no money.
That's right.
So you could be talking about something else.
Right.
But if, like, they're not pushing it in a sense, so it's like we got to be able to still talk about whatever we want without having to be forced or dictated through the monetary gain, or not feeling like we got to crash out for the money. Because right. It's a lot of internet crashing out. It's a lot of real life crashing out.
That's
for
right.
the bag.
For the bag.
For the
right.
attention. Because if I can make this attention pop, I'm going to get the money.
Right.
And, you know.
But you're in the attention economy.
So it's like, if you're not getting the bag, even the person, like, and then it's like, you know, it's villainized for somebody who's talking some real shit or the right shit to even ask for money. So they make that seem like it's a problem. So if you're doing good things, it's bad to ask for money or make money off the good right. thing. But it's okay to make money off all the bad shit in the world.
All that shit is a go.
We gonna kill each other. We gonna die. We gonna, you know what I mean? Fuck you. Like the real shit that go viral. Like if we was on here, fuck this nigga, a bitch. When I see this nigga, da-da. Yo, that shit would be, like, the numbers would be super crazy up. Because if we had a target on the person, this is who we're slaying today, and he's going to die today, and we about to body him on the internet and right. catch a body. Nigga, right. we going super viral, but going super viral on some shit that's saving your mind and things like that for some reason.
Right.
Yeah, I don't want to make that go that too viral.
Yeah, that's too much.
Well, you see,
and I don't
want to
put
see,
money behind that.
You see the marketing scheme that Sexy Red presented just recently with her latest video. I don't know if you guys have seen that video yet. But it's a way of engineering that they're utilizing with Sexy Red that, you know, is forecasting all over the planet, and it's affecting every demographic and every age group. So if you watch the video, the level of marketing genius, and when I say genius, I'm saying that loosely, you know, the way that she was able to implement the late 2000s into it, and then she brought in the dance back into the scene with it. Everybody had, you know, the white tees, the headbands, you know, she brought the roller skating element into it, you know, she even had, you know, Drake in it. She had one of the most popular Twitch celebrities in it, Aiden Ross. So she touched on every aspect to where it engages children, it engages adults, it engages the hood, because it was shot in the hood, but again, it had the aesthetic of more of that, because it even had the nerve to have Fabo in it from Atlanta. Yeah. And he was doing this thing that he was doing back in the early 2000s in the video. So the way that they presented that aesthetic with that specific video, they knew that the feng shui that they performed in that with the imagery, it touches the hearts of a lot of different demographics all at one time.
Small screen.
So, huh?
Small screen. It was small screen, web-centric, user-generated type of content. So it looked like something that anybody could do. The average person on TikTok. Oh, did we lose our Kibalon? There you go.
Not bad. Yeah, but you were saying it's small screen.
Yeah, I was saying that it was small screen content, and it was web-centric, and it was user-generated content, what they call UGC. So it basically looked like something that anybody could capture with their phone.
Exactly.
And the frame in which they caught it in is a similar frame that you see in Hood 101 TikTok videos. So, yeah, they bodied that. They made her super relatable. And then, like you said, they tapped into nostalgia. And they're pitching to the generation that I was talking about, the people that was born, the Y2K Osiris babies, the ones that were, remember, Isis, her name is Isis. Ice Spice name is Isis.
Mm-hmm.
She's born January the 1st, 2000.
Damn. What?
Yeah. And then when you do her, when you do the numbers on her and everything, that's like a master number. But yeah, she's January the 1st, 2000. So she literally represents that whole generation of kids.
Wow.
Right? So when Soulja Boy popped in, what, 2007?
Something like that.
Yeah. I remember that. They were 7 years old. So that's the big homie right there. Yeah, that, so when they do the video, that's the nostalgia speaking to that niche right there.
Yeah. Damn.
Genius.
So she was born on the first day of the new millennium.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Y2K was supposed to happen.
And I feel as if they're gonna continue that push. They're gonna continue that push. You know, it's, of course, with Sexy Red, you know, she's bringing the whole culture in tenfold. And then again, sprinkling a little bit of not only nostalgia, but she's attracting the youth, the younger generation. So, you know, it's again, just like we spoke about, the fact that the idea is to, you know, not only create our own media, but it's the monies that's funding these individuals, that's pushing them.
Right.
You know, again, if we come out and we start speaking God body, it's not going to get as many views as opposed to a nigga that's, you know, talking mad shit and just completely, you know, being disruptive and you know, doing shit that's completely contrary to, you know, any type of level of knowledge itself.
And it's so entertaining. We can't you watching these niggas crash out. I'm a victim. I've watched the crash out. And I'm like, I can't believe that they're really going that crazy on the internet.
But like, what cooperation creates corporations.
Right.
Cooperation to create corporations and collaborations, right? Collaborations will create collaboration. You know, cooperation create corporation. What do you mean? What I mean is, once again, it goes back to its responsibility. The numbers are there. The numbers are there. If it's more than 1,000, you good.
Yeah.
I'm counting at least 1 million, and I'm lowballing like an MFer. I'm saying 1 million of our people who are responsible, who don't got their ego in the way, will come together and collaborate. And just say, you know what? We're just going to create. Oh, I'm sorry. Collaboration creates coalitions.
Mm.
Right?
Mm. Hold on. Yeah, that's a bomb.
Cooperation creates corporations. I don't want no new friends without EINs.
Fire.
Bang, bang.
I don't want no new friends without EINs.
Red, you talking heavy right
now. We got to grow the fuck up.
Yeah.
You understand? Stop playing games because it's 2024. Aliens showed up to the mall in Miami. Nigga, we're in another quarter of this motherfucking game.
Yeah.
This ain't, you know what I'm saying? It's not Michael Jackson's world anymore. This is not your mama's world. This is a different plane of existence that we all have woken up in, wherever the fuck we at. But in this slice of the universe, shit is real. And you literally could do damn near anything. You got to do shit that hasn't been done before. I'm not entertaining no conversations about trying to keep up with old records. They all here to be shattered, right? And now we have we got the people. We put in the work. We did the heavy lifting. You know what I'm talking about? We woke the people up.
Facts.
We woke the people up, goddammit. And the numbers, we need a head count.
All is possible. All is possible.
In this election year, in this election year, where this is about people campaigning and counting heads, and they giving y'all the choice between a knife and a gun, two wings of a goddamn vulture. Now, I won't even diss the vulture like that. I really won't. Two wings of an ostrich. Maybe not even that. A fucking dodo bird.
To this day.
Because it's not an eagle. So check this out.
Yeah.
You got something called a blockchain now. Right? So the blockchain is basically saying that I have a locked in supporter. I don't got no supporter that I got to catch up to. I don't got to get no support. I got to email. I don't got a supporter that I got to wait when the album drops on Friday. I hit those numbers. Nah, we on the blockchain now.
Okay.
It's a different game. Now you got something called smart contracts, right? So now you're on the blockchain. You locked in, right? There's no wiggling out of that. There's like, yo, I agreed to sign up. And I rock with this company, I rock with this label, or I rock with this artist. Then you got a smart contract, and that smart contract basically is you giving permission for whatever transaction may take place with your crypto wallet, right? Because when you do on a blockchain, you lock in. You also lock in with your wallet.
Mm.
Wallet got your address. Your address is who you are all across that board right there, across multiple blockchains. So without saying too much, you basically live in a day and time where if you got 1 million followers, you got 1 million supporters. Everything you drop is platinum. Let's stop playing games. Really, the formula that has to be corrected is the trust, but also it's the quote unquote is that one person. You know what I mean? Mm. What they call the fan. Or what they call the supporter, or what they call the member, right?
Facts.
It's not the artist.
The subscriber.
The subscriber, right? Y'all complete the cipher.
Facts.
If we not talking to our shareholders,
and
right?
Hit that like button. We see
that like button.
We just cracked over 100.
Yeah,
so let's go.
Yeah, get those numbers up. Share this joint.
Bang,
that part.
Bang,
you know what I'm talking
bang.
About?
Let's go viral
yeah,
tonight.
Yeah, let's go to viral tonight. Why not?
To this day.
You know what I'm talking about? We back like we never left.
Facts.
So at the end of the day, shareholders, you can have a conversation with shareholders because they're locked and loaded. They have certificates. They have an incentivized reason to be there and root on for the big dogs.
Yeah.
Right? You take that same formula, that same mentality, and you apply it to what it is that you're doing because you a whole stock. You know what I'm talking about? In white socks. You a walking, breathing stock. You are a commodity. You a brand. We live in a brand economy. It's new rules outside.
Facts.
We live in the economy of attention. We live in a trust economy. We live in a gig economy.
Yep.
We live in a digital economy. We live in a quote-unquote lust economy.
A creative economy.
We live in a creative economy. So everything that we was talking about over the years with facts, initiative, you know what I'm talking about? With the evolution will be digitized.
Facts.
With stream chases and
I
whatnot.
I remember this.
You remember all of that?
10 years ago.
10 years ago. You booked me for the Facts in Long Island.
You came to Long Island.
Right. And we laid this down.
Yes.
And we was like, yo, in the future, you're going to be an entrepreneur.
Facts.
How you spell that, Red?
Bang. Bang. Bang.
That's a fact, though.
I want to Google that.
I probably had like 10,000 subscribers at the time. I
had about 10 bands on them.
On both channels,
on
though.
On both channels. But he listened, and he wasn't one of them people that was like the audacity of this dude, this old head, trying to tell me something. And that's what people get in their own way, because nobody on this planet could tell me that I was staring them wrong over the last 20 clips.
Facts.
And you can't point me to somebody who was giving them that same cloth. You know what I'm talking about? The cloth is Valentino.
Nah, facts. Red came to the crib, all that. Came through, showed love. You know what I'm saying? Opened the whole door for us to actually be able to walk there. Red allowed me to build with him and actually build. Like, with
right.
You, like, Kid Life Production is me and Red Pill work, honestly. Right. Like, I got a chance to travel and meet a lot of different people, but Red was the power behind that. Right. I got to say that. Well, every
Rich Phil, excuse me, pardon me. That's why the moniker has changed. It's Rich Phil.
Rich Phil.
That's Rich Phil Rich doing Phil. That. That's the manager part of me. That's the consultant part of me. That's the business side. You feel me? I work with my people because my network is my network.
Facts.
So now the brother's network has dramatically have increased, and that's now I'm part of that node and whatnot. So just sitting next to the brother, my Cash App is automatically going.
We up.
Yeah, we up, baby.
To this day.
And you feel your credit score rise.
And I know Red been putting in work in, but I got my 10,000 hours in.
That's right. You know what I mean? That's right. And that's very important. So there's masters walking around right now who have mastered their craft. And now they have they've given birth to businesses and brands, entities and whatnot that they passing on to their little ones. And they out here building families and building movements. You know what I mean? And that's what this whole thing is about. And it's only going to continue. Mm-hmm. And we've entered into a new space and a new age and a new era and in a new epoch. That's why we named this conversation tonight, Crossing the Bridge. There's nothing whatsoever. If you could gauge the way things are going, you could breathe a little bit easier these days. Why? Because London Bridge is falling down. That's why. Mm.
Let me ask you this, Pill.
I'm just saying, as Babylon falls,
yes,
you rise. As Babylon falls, you rise. You can't have it any other way. They actually got this shit built on top of your shit, by the way.
Yeah.
Don't even cry for this mundane type of architecture that you see out here.
So it's the seeds under the city that's growing now and destroying the city.
Yes. The cities are under the cities. You understand?
So they're coming up. So now it got to be a destruction of whatever's on top.
That's right. Because what they tried to bury is now resurfacing, right? Mm. Like the movie that they put out that was called The Flower Moon, Killers of the Flower Moon. Did you see that, Al-Kibalon?
I haven't seen that. Is that with Leonardo DiCaprio?
Yes, yes. That exposed.
I haven't
so
seen
much.
That one yet.
Yes, that was a body slam. And they kind of like blackballed it at the award show. They didn't want it to win too many awards because it would have highlighted that flick. They want people to forget about that movie because that movie was exposing the levels of barbarity and the levels of terrorism that they basically stole oil wealth and actually land, right? Which, you know, it's a whole nother conversation. But this whole thing is falling apart. Let's just say that things are being revealed on a daily basis that never would have been revealed before. There's so many contradictions out there that's just staring people in their faces and whatnot. But meanwhile, these children can't read and whatnot. And meanwhile, these children don't want to be lied to in these schools anymore. And meanwhile, these children are being traumatized with these quote-unquote, you know, with these agents of the state, you know what I mean, that have agendas and whatnot, that are performing all type of lewd activities and questionable acts and borderline pedophilia in front of innocent minds in the name of what they call democracy. And it's a mockery.
Yeah.
They actually have something where they replace Easter, even though I understand that in and of itself is a farce, but they gave Joe Biden said transgender visibility day.
Yeah, because it's like, you know, like you said, if Easter is something that's made up, created to sell money, it's like, how can we upgrade Easter?
We're going
to
just keep this shit going. Because
we need to upgrade every new holiday.
That's right.
We need everything. You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever. What's the new thing? You know what I'm saying? Because we're promoting and made other things legal now.
If we got to continue to show that this shit is falling to pieces, like Al-Kibalon, did you think that you would live to see the day where the president, not the president of, like, you know, the FDA or the president of, like, Hallmark cards, the actual president of the United States say, You know what? That Easter thing, that shit really hasn't been working out for us lately.
Yeah, I ain't feeling it.
I ain't feeling it. Ever since that American Gods episode with Ishtar and whatnot, we've been at Easter's neck. You know what I mean? So we decided that we was gonna give the transgender a day to get fresh. They're gonna come to Coney Island and whatnot in their flyest Moschino. Like, what the hell?
But you know what's crazy is once you make it a law, we all gotta follow it, right?
Who's we?
No. I'm just saying that's the game they play.
They told France to leave Africa.
It's like law. You see the stop sign.
That's right.
I don't give a fuck what you don't have to. You can speed through it.
That's
but
right.
Just know you could get a fucking ticket.
That's right.
For speeding through it. So that's what I'm saying. Once they make these things law, you gotta watch your mouth. Watch what you say. Watch whatever.
That's crazy.
Or, you know, we'll demonetize or we'll do this or there will be a ticket.
Yeah, that's crazy.
So as long as you can say, fuck the ticket and I got the ticket money, talk your shit.
Babylon is falling. You know what I mean? Babylon a fall. You dig?
Did anybody see it?
They couldn't even celebrate Christmas in Jerusalem, in Bethlehem. I'll keep it long.
Yeah, you can hear me?
Yes, sir.
He's very low.
You're low, though.
At least to us, like to me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know. I've been cutting in like mad times, but y'all probably
yeah,
can
so
hear
it's
me.
Like it, might be low. I need to hear him a lot clearer. You know what I'm saying? At least on my end.
Yeah. Me too.
Yeah, no, it's all good. I was just getting ready to
That's
say.
That's much better. I feel like he's a part of the conversation now, a little better.
Yeah, it's different when you're trying to pop your shit like on the other side of the world. Like, I'm not there at the desk, so it hit a little different.
Now we can hear you. Right now, I can hear you perfectly, so go ahead. Talk your shit.
Yeah. Okay. No, I was getting ready to say, because I just came across it, where they introduce a new gender. Gender X?
Yes.
I just came across that, like, 2 hours ago, and I just seen that. But like you said,
the
hell is a gender?
I go into that, Red, because I haven't did a deep dive.
I don't know. Hold on.
You said 2 hours ago. What you hear about it? What is that?
Yeah, what was revealed to you, brother?
Nah, it was a IG post. I didn't read into it. It was right before we jumped on, but they said that they were introducing like another gender, and it's gender X. It's whoever you want to be is what I got from it, the little bit that I read. Yeah, right, so right. It's gender X, like, you know, you could be whatever.
Non-binary.
Like, so, it's non-binary, you know.
You just
so,
androgynous, yeah. You just like, I'm just X.
It's a third gender that differs from M, male, or F, female. The term X gender came into use in the later 1990s, popularized by queer organizations in Kansia, especially in Osaka. So this is in, Japan. The term is used in place of non-binary queer gender in Japan.
Interesting.
Gender X. X gender.
Interesting.
Yeah.
I guess they all on X Twitter then.
Hey. X. Oh, that's a bomb. That's bomb. A bomb right there.
Bomb.
Neither male or female.
I just know that we are currently in Jonathan Majors' multiverse. You know what I mean? Every day it's some new shit that convinces me that we are on a Nebuchadnezzar looping through all type of, you know, interesting realities at once. And we're subjugated to the news cycle. Because going back to what was saying earlier, because our reality is curated, right? Now we have an algorithm. It's hard to fathom what the hell were we getting our news sources from and just the word of the day prior to social media in the algorithm, right?
Yeah.
Like back in the days when you got fresh, right? How did people know that you was fresh?
They seen me.
But what about the people that lived in Haiti that didn't see you and they knew you got fresh? What about the people down, your family members who was in Florida that wasn't in they wasn't in Long Island when you was getting fresh? They knew that you got fresh, though. Who told them?
Somebody.
Right.
Somebody told them.
And
somebody.
They were so descriptive that people were able to paint a picture in their head as to what you was wearing, how that shit looked like. Yeah. So when they saw the picture, it exactly matched what they thought you was looking like. Fast forward today, we just have Instagram and Facebook. If you wasn't wearing it on one of these platforms, guess what? You wasn't wearing it.
Mm.
Okay?
Yeah.
So now we have curated existence. Do you know that the company, one of the top companies in the world, which is going to be the number one company in a span of about a month, NVIDIA, they actually have a clone of the world called Earth Part 2, where every single part of the world is a digital clone. Do you know about that?
No, never heard of it. Wait, so say that one more time. Like, was it a cloned Earth?
They cloned.
Uh-huh.
They made a digital twin, a digital clone.
Okay.
Of the entire Earth. Okay. But not just the entire Earth. Everything inside of that Earth is cloned underneath this project, this very expansive and very heavily funded project called Earth 2 by NVIDIA.
So it's like there's me and you in that Earth.
Yeah, they cloned all of us easily through social media.
Yeah, so
all of our profiles.
So I guess what? So now they can use all of that to kind of manipulate scenarios, I guess?
Yes, they utilize it to manipulate scenarios.
That makes sense.
Even though that's very crazy, but they use it for all type of quote-unquote model testing. But yeah, there's a cloned Earth.
I believe
developers may have access to it. Excuse me?
Go ahead, King.
You hear me?
Yes, sir.
No, I was getting ready to say, that even itself gets into a deeper physics when you're creating duplicates or templates, because, that was effective back, when you talk about the Philadelphia experiment and all of that.
Yeah.
They were trying to control things at a distance by utilizing the space in between the thing that they were trying to control, so in order to do it, they had to re-engineer the original thing that they were trying to manipulate and create a template out of it. And thus, by setting up a specific resonance, they were able to control that thing at a distance by utilizing the medium in between that thing and, the original concept. So, that goes into, because eventually it'll lead in, and it may sound like two completely opposite concepts, but this concept is going to eventually lead into telepathy.
Mm.
Nevertheless, it's going to move into, that's why, like I said, again, they're probing the invisible matter because they're trying to figure out how they can utilize this medium to teleport information from here to China instantaneously, and it's not through any, whether it's computer, cell phone, it's completely wireless, but it's through the advent of utilizing, the space, which again, they're calling invisible matter, in order to make this transition happen. That goes into, phantom DNA and, things of that nature, which is a whole nother conversation. But right. Yeah, I just find that interesting that they're duplicating and creating clones. And then Red, too, Red, because you and I, we got a whole clone walking around that look just like us, right. And I never did my due. Yeah, because we're twins, for those who don't know. Never did my due diligence in like really looking into that concept of a twin, even though I know it's like mass spiritual, that concept in and of itself is a phenomena. So I that's something that I definitely want to tap into, and understand like what is that, and also too, are they looking into the body? Because I did a little bit of research on that, just a tad bit, a couple of nights, or probably like 4 or 5 nights ago. And they're still trying to figure out, how to, and this is twin talk, family. They're still trying to figure out, how the zygote splits, how that happens. They don't, there's a mystery. Like, they don't know how that works. But they said two twins have the exact same DNA. So my question is, if I have kids, But if my brother were to go get, you know, a DNA test, would that also be his children if we have the same exact DNA?
Right.
That's like I said, it's just it's twin conversation right now. It's just a thought. But you know, saying that to say, like with them duplicating and creating clones, I'm like, are they fully aware of how a twin is created? Like, and then they're trying to imitate that level of microbiology, or like what is that? You know what I'm saying? So
right. Keep in mind, science has been able to manipulate twin births. So there's been an explosion of, you know, 4, 5, and 6.
Damn.
By way of manipulation of the quote unquote egg. Science played a part in that.
Yeah.
So they've learned how to do that. There's no telling that they've also learned how to basically create twins.
Yeah.
And this process of cloning is going to be intricately related into whatever the science behind twins are. So imagine if they can make, they could make 8 versions of you.
Yeah, like we seen in that Arnold Schwarzenegger movie.
And the Will Smith movie,
yeah.
Gemini. Right?
Yeah. But remember the Arnold Schwarzenegger movie, he kept killing Lord. There was just multiple of them, like so many, like they always kept creating one.
Right.
To the point they had numbers or something, or under their lip or something.
Right.
And they're like, damn, you like number 5. Like...
Right. So,
and that was like what, early 90s? Like,
yeah. So at this point, there's no doubt in my mind, not only that clones exist, but because of the technology that they have of AI clones and creating digital twins with HeyGen, right? The HeyGen technology, deep fake technology is now at a level to whereas you can see somebody online actually doing something, and that does not have to be that person. And you would swear up and down beyond any reasonable doubt that your eyes are telling you that that's that person.
Yeah.
But because of simple over-the-counter technology that the average person can use right now, I refuse at this point moving forward. You have to really, you know, you could be manipulated into seeing something that you swear that you saw, and it's not what you think you saw.
Yeah.
We've crossed that bridge. Right? Once again, the title of tonight's show is Crossing the Bridge. There's certain bridges that you cross that your ass cannot go back over. Once that bridge is crossed, there's no going back over the bridge. The bridge crumbles. The bridge has fallen like the bridge in Baltimore.
Yeah.
Okay? Once these bridges burn, like when you fall out with somebody, and that bridge burnt, and you burnt one of your connects, or you ran on the plug, or you broke up with somebody that you was in a deep relationship with, or there's a business, or Dame and Jay, right? The burning of the bridge, the collapsing of the bridge, the ending of something. We are ending something in a few days, y'all. Not me, not our Kibalon, not knowledge. We, everybody. Some people are knowledgeable about it. Some are not. Me, personally, I'm not staring at the goddamn eclipse. I'm good on that. I ain't even going outside. I'm in a bunker, huh? Like Archie, bro. I'm in a bunker, man.
Yeah.
I'm going to just play this one bunkered up.
Yeah.
You dig?
Yeah, they planning something for you.
Yeah, I'm good on that. I'm going to have some shrooms and some paintbrushes and a flute. I'm playing it safe.
Andre 3000.
3000. I'm a ground and whatnot. I want to feel what's coming up off this electromagnetic blanket, this bed. I'm good on everything else. I ain't gonna play with computers, and I'm damn sure not staring at the sun and the eclipse.
Let me ask a question. What does one do once the bridge collapses?
You keep it moving, brother, because what the Moors did when they burnt the ships, right? They conquered. There was no turning back. If you turn back, you lose your head. So once the ships got burned, they had to go ahead and press on. And that's how they won. That's how they was able to basically advance and you know, begin this glorious age of the Moors in Spain.
That's symbolic to so many things.
There has to be confidence. There has to be courageous. You want a hero's journey.
on that journey, as you go through that journey, nobody on a hero's journey is going backwards.
Yeah.
In a video game, in Zelda, once you cross the bridge, you don't go back across the bridge, right? In real life and whatnot, once you get on a certain level, you don't go back. Everybody can't go.
Everybody. Shout out to Benny.
You dig? Everybody can't go, rightfully so. Everybody can't go after this eclipse, after America gets crossed and whatnot. Bang, everybody bang, can't go.
Bang. Yeah.
I'm not walking around playing games talking about I'm a Democrat or I'm a black Republican or it's Trump or it's Joe Biden and all of this. I'm not playing that game no more. You got to close we got to close the chapter on certain things.
Facts.
This whole shit been a shit show, bro. Down to the goddamn eclipse. This whole them having us paying all of this rent. Niggas on the run from the mortgage. On the run eating. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, instead of niggas on the run eating, niggas on the run skiing. You know what I mean? Going state to state. Moving around. I'll travel dolo state to state. Everybody trying to make a way. All of this hustling and bustling. No. How about you're on your land? You're on your moral land. You got the resource. You got access to resources. You got access to shelter. You got access to all type of subsidiaries. You got access to these crops. Your ass supposed to be selling your hemp, your marijuana legally, like how New York is popping right now.
Yeah.
How they got turkey bags walking around with. That's supposed to be, you supposed to have a hammer. You supposed to have your biscuit on your side. You're supposed to be experiencing all of these things.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's time to govern our mental. It's time to focus on a body politic rather than these politicians and politics. It's time to focus on counting a few numbers. I'm looking for 144,000.
Yeah.
Not good men and good women. This is not a fucking army commercial. It doesn't. I'm looking for 144,000 chosen people who want to make a difference, who accept the fact that they may eat a little bit of chicken every now and then.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They might not meditate all day. They might not know how to do the downward doggy. I'm not talking necessarily to all those people. Yeah. I'm just speaking to everybody on the road. Like, if this was a caravan, I just need y'all to be willing to be counted.
Yeah, let's have the same purpose and goal. We don't all have to be doing the exact same thing, but as long as we have that purpose, a goal to want to have that success that we're all looking for, yes, and we could work together, I think those are the people we need. Like,
could we identify the W, right?
Yes.
Simply identify what the W is,
yes,
vote on it, and then move forward towards it without anybody sabotaging one another.
And do your part. Like, you have a part to do,
right,
do your part.
Do it. Like, nobody else can do it.
Trust me, because it's going to matter. Like,
it
when
will.
You do your part, how you supposed to do, don't worry about what Pill's doing. He's doing
right.
his part. Don't
right.
worry about what I'm doing or, you know what I'm saying, what the brother's doing. Like, do your part.
That's right.
To the highest level. That's how we win in this shit. Like, come on.
Like, how a team is playing Final Four, right? Pay attention. Watch any type of sports that deals with sportsmanship and team players, right, or teamwork that makes the dream, and then apply it to your situation. Watch the Final Four, watch the finals of the NBA, and see how teams work. The forward don't got to worry about doing the job of the center.
Exactly.
And the shooting guard is covered. Everything is taken care of so he could do what the fuck he came to do.
Yeah. You could score 100 like Wilt, my nigga, but that don't mean a championship.
It don't mean a chip. It's the team that works like a machine and whatnot. Shout out. What would Machine do, huh? Shout out to Machine and them. Right? It's the team that's well-oiled. It's the team that works to make the dream work. Teamwork makes the dream work. So as soon as we figure that out, then we could talk about all of these shows and all of these broadcasts, because we in a studio broadcasting not just news anymore. We giving you content, bro.
Facts.
Like, this is different.
A part of our lives, because we live this shit.
Living this shit, bro. Y'all seeing us grow in front of y'all. Y'all seeing the evolution of people. You seeing the growth. You seeing the ups and the downs, the ebbs and the flows, the sunny days and the rainy days.
Facts.
Because we've been through all of that together. You know what I'm talking about? Like, don't get it effed up. I'm able to celebrate right now and pop my shit because y'all see me on a goddamn camera phone in the crib, you know what I mean, with the smoke alarm going on.
Still working. I don't give a fuck.
And it's still going on.
We not stopping.
I'm talking about, still working.
And you know what's ill about that is, you know, when you are in the spot that you want to be, you've prepared yourself. So it's like the win is just easier. It's like it's not, I don't have to try to do this.
I don't got to try to do this.
This is already what I've been doing. Like, I did it in the worst conditions. I drove in the snow in the blizzard. And got the interviews in the cut.
You feel me? In the
with
cut.
The battery dying, whole like I did that. So when I'm got major product, like what?
Right.
I did this shit with nothing. What
with
are you talking
not a
about?
Thing. You saw me pushing the shopping cart back in the suitcase. Remember, I used to carry
of
a
course,
suitcase everywhere.
Of course.
Like I was going somewhere. How about that?
But
huh?
Hustling though all the time, making sure y'all on your game. Y'all
always
teaching,
had new drip.
And always had merch.
Always
jewelry,
had merch.
Whatever
bang,
it is.
Bang.
Always
bang,
had on deck.
And gave back because you would still give content. You would still build. You would still put people on.
Always putting people on. Wasn't on YouTube just talking shit. I could have talked my, you know what I mean? But giving the game up. Not selling it. Giving it up.
Yeah.
Saying, yo, the evolution will be digitized. Y'all need digital convergence. Learn to build with other channels. Don't go against them.
Yeah.
You will work better together. That's the resolve that I made, and I start working with Sonetta, and the rest is history and whatnot.
And stop being scared of giving somebody the information because you're scared they might do better than you.
You feel me?
Like, what kind of dumb shit is that? Like, if everybody who work with me and know what I do, I give everybody the game.
Right.
If you don't use it, that's on you. And the people who I've given it to have won at crazy levels, surpassed me and did things. So it's like, I'm their number one fan.
You feel me? Like, I see Akibalon. I see you out there teaching students and whatnot, giving them the game, you know, raising up a student body and whatnot and giving them the opportunity to teach and to shine. You know, what do you feel is your obligations as a student and as a teacher to the ones that are coming behind you?
My thing is, you know, and I've said this, you know, in the past, but there's a difference, you know, between taking in information and then becoming the information. You know, the first things first.
Yeah.
Like like we were building on is to be able to play your role and understand what your role is. And then once you understand what your role is, the level of intelligence that's encoded within us.
Right.
You know, but the idea is to set yourself up in environments, you know, whether it's music, you know, the city, whether it's, you know, your home, you want to set your environment up in a way that's going to stimulate, you know, that reservoir of energy that's naturally, you know, encoded within you and bring it to the
right.
conscious mind. But you just got to figure out, you know, what you're good at. And, you know, we all get, you know, spiritual, but a lot of us also got caught up in being spiritual,
right?
You know, when it's convenient, you know, the convenience of being spiritual, you know,
right.
It's like we sometimes get into more of like cosplay and, you know, masquerade, but at the end of the day, you know, we don't want to turn consciousness into another religion, you know?
Yeah. I mean, it's kind of too late for that.
Yeah, I know it is. Nah, it is. And that's why I'm speaking on it. So, you know, the idea is to, like I said, you want to own in on what your specific passion is, what you love to do.
Yes.
And eliminate, the minute you get up every morning, like we were saying, eliminate jumping on the phone or getting on IG, because in my opinion, that devalues, you know, not only yourself to a certain extent, but it takes away from the imagination, because when you're now being exposed to a level of subjective programming, you lose the idea to think for yourself. Right. You know, so the later of your day starts to begin, you know, predicated on how it started, you know, where, you know, if you were to get up, you were to sit up and meditate, you were to clear the mind out, go to a place of no thought and allow yourself to be a receiver. Naturally, you'll see how your day will pan out and things will play out, you know, relatively smooth for you. You know, spirit moves and spirit moves with least resistance. So, you know, the idea is to, again, make sure that you lose the sense of distraction first, you know, whether it's cutting off the TV, whether it's, you know, eliminating some of the foods out of your diet, getting rid of that instantaneous gratification, you know, via emotional eating, whether you got to go on a, you know, a run or a hike, or whether you got to start building the body up through working out. You want to get to a place, again, mentally, where you're at a state of peace, which brings a level of poise, and then now you can begin to think rationally. And now, again, the information that you may have taken in a book 2 or 3 weeks prior, not only are you retaining the information, but now you're becoming and demonstrating the information that you've been taking on. So, you know, it's just about honing in on your passion, doing what you love to do, clearing the mind, lessen the distraction, and then become a receiver and, you know, embark upon your journey.
I know on April the 6th, you were bringing back the God Body Challenge, right? So our network and the brothers and sisters who are tapped in with you could actually begin to do that, which you speak of, which is to basically block out the distractions and be more proactive and actually move forward and move towards sculpting a God Body during this New Year's. Can you give them a little bit of insight on that and how they could tap in?
Yeah, absolutely. So April 6th, you know, the God Body Challenge. With this one, it's real special. I'm doing it with a brother out from North Carolina. Me and him are hosting it, but he's a martial artist. You know, he's been doing it for over a decade. We had a live 2 nights ago, you know, where we got into a little bit of the metaphysics of martial arts and, you know, the importance of introducing martial arts more than just a physical component, but also more of like a meditative, you know, component as well. So, know, with this God Body Challenge, you know, during the duration of the fast itself, you know, we're going to, you know, entertain the family with, you know, different videos of, you know, techniques through martial arts, hand-to-hand combat, you know, things of that nature to get us more, not only in a warrior spirit, but get us to a place where, again, we can show a level of discipline, you know, that inevitably manipulate our reality in an amazing way. So, you know, we're dealing with the year of the dragon. So it's in accordance to what, you know, we got lined up for this God Body Challenge. But it's a 3 to 5 day fast, no solid foods, and we're doing just strictly coconut water. And of course, you know, we're lining it up, you know, with a major celestial event that's taking place. So how I always break it down, the God Body Challenge specifically, you know, is I say, you know, your brain sees fasting as a level of stress, a cognitive stress. So what your brain naturally does is it stimulates what you call adaptive stress response pathways. Adaptive stress response pathways then lead into, say, day 2 or 3, lead into a protein or proteins being developed in the brain called brain-derived neurotrophic factors. And brain-derived neurotrophic factors is what is responsible for rewiring the brain via neuroplasticity, because now you're developing a larger brain just through fasting alone. And the brain not only sees cognitive stress through fasting, but it sees it through reading books that are tough to get through or watching lectures that's hard to digest. You know, a level of stress is good because you want your brain to go into that survival mode, which kicks up, like I said, not only the BDNF, which is brain-derived neurotrophic factors, but it builds up more mitochondria in the hippocampus, which allows you during the fast to retain information, whether you're reading a book or even whether you're going through martial arts and learning certain sequences and rhythms and combos and things of that nature. So, you know, it's important. And I feel like especially aligning this God Body Challenge up with these celestial events and allowing the brain more access to the magnetic field, which is our mind, you know, coming out of the fast, you know, we'll come out with epiphanies, more creative ideas, you know, more intuition. And it's because we allowed our brain and fashioned our brain in such a way to where that our brain not only developed and developed more neurons, but also it gave us more access to the magnetic field where all the information exists. So, you know, this is going to be a very powerful fast, and it's monumental. And shout out to my guy out from North Carolina, martial artist, you know, amazing energy. For those who haven't tapped in, tap into the live. It's on my page. We're going to go live again April 5th, which is Friday, and we're going to get deeper into the science and the metaphysics of martial arts itself. But, yeah, God Body Challenge, April 6th, 3 to 5 day fast. No solid foods, just coconut water.
Fire, fire, yo. I'm on that. I'm on that. You know what I mean? Yeah, I'm excited about that. I'm enthusiastic about that. You know what I'm saying? And like you said, for the family out there, April the 7th, mark it on your calendars. We making history. Red pill, blue pill, Alkibalon. We will be presenting to you Vulture Culture. Three different lectures, all right? Three different lectures underneath the banner of Vulture Culture. We're going to be delivering on April the 7th, okay? We are starting 8 p.m. Eastern. We're going to go into the 8th, more than likely. We'll cross the midnight. We will be filming it. It will be available for replay. It will be filmed, and it will be live stream only. Live stream only. Live stream only. Only on Zoom, all right? It's not going to be live. It will be live stream, and we look forward to seeing y'all in the building. The next show that I'll be doing, well, I'll have Brother Blue Pill, where he'll be talking about his segment that he's going to be rolling out. Y'all already know, we do classics. So this right here is going to be one of them ones that, you know, is in a long time waiting. Me and Alkibalon, we've been cooking. So, you know, and let's not talk about what Blue been doing. He been going crazy.
Yeah, you know. On the Patreon.
Say it again. Yes, that will be available for my top Patreon Supreme members. For my Supreme members, you are going to have access to the April 7th, okay? So y'all are good and whatnot. Shout out to all of y'all. Shout out to everybody that followed us through the 4 week of the AI Empire, how to build an AI digital empire in 30 days. We completed the fourth course. This is coming up. This is Amplified Intelligence. I will be in Atlanta in the daytime. This is live. This is going to be live in the daytime from 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. I will be in Atlanta doing a presentation with Brother Dr. Rick Mathis, and that's Amplified Intelligence, and we'll be dealing with AI and filmmaking. I'm an executive producer on an AI movie, and I'll be showing y'all the trailer and talking about some stuff in AI and filmmaking. Yeah. Blue Pill right here. This is going to be his presentation. Pope Pablo, he's pulling up. He's going to be killing it. You already know what it is. KTLUniversity.com is where the tickets are at. KTLUniversity.com is where the tickets are at. Make sure you go ahead and get your tickets. We even have...
To this day.
We even have something for y'all. Bang. Bang, where for the first bang, for the people bang, the first bang, 10 people bang, who get your tickets, we are going to bless you bang, with a bonus bang, bang, with a bundle pack of the four lectures that we did with the brother Alkibalon over the bang, years and whatnot bang, bang, that's going to be free of charge only for 10 people though, okay?
Day,
only for
day,
10 people. So for the first day, 10 we'll count you up and we're going to bless you not just with a ticket, but you'll get the whole bundle of the four lectures that we put together over the years. Each one of them are classics, okay? Each one of these are classic. What's good with that airplay code? Yeah, so with that being said, Knowledge, do you have any last words that you want to leave the people with? You know what I'm talking about?
I just want to say, you know, stay true to yourself, follow your goals and your dreams, stay positive, treat yourself right, you know, and just be on the lookout for future things I got coming up. I'm working with Red. I got some things on my own that I'm doing. I got a show that I'm working on as well. I filmed that first episode already.
Oh, congratulations.
I shot it with Rain 910, you know.
The Rain. Legend. Shout
my guy
Rain.
Rain, you know what I'm saying? He Rain, putting that paint in. So that episode is coming out really soon.
He made the Red Opal beat. That's the producer behind Red Opal.
Yo, you on one of his albums. I think What Would Jesus Do or something like that.
Yeah,
I heard you on it. I'm like, oh, shit, my nigga Red on here?
Yeah,
like,
I ate food.
Let me find out. But yeah, salute to him. We had a great build. That's coming out. Know the Game with Knowledge of God. That's what it's called. So be on the lookout for that. It's going to be exclusively on hiphopisreal.com. Make sure you follow me, subscribe. Everything Hip Hop is Real. Because hip-hop is real.
You dig? Hip-hop is real. You know what I'm talking about? Shout out to the whole family over there. So, yeah, like I said, we got a lot of things coming up. The month of April just started for all of my Patreons. Be sure to be at the town hall. This is going to be, if you thought the other ones were loaded, this one right here is going to be super loaded the first time we have a Patreon town hall. In the post KTL Studios world. So there's a lot going on, and we're going to put y'all on. There's a lot of opportunities that have opened up. Let's drop a bomb to that, right? 420, the album is dropping. 48 Pillars of Power, all right?
Dope.
48.
To this day.
On 4-4.
To this day.
We're having a listening party at Industry ATL 400 Loyola. If anybody in the audience want to tap in with me, you got to tap in with me because I don't know who you are. So on IG or anywhere that you get in touch with me, just get in touch with me. It's invite only. It's not open to the public, okay? 420, we're going to have a party, and Brother Rich will be hosting. That's going to be the release of not just the album, but we have a book, okay? There's a book coming with 48 Pillars of Power, Volume 1, and that book is going to have the 12 Pillars of Power, and we'll be dropping 12 songs for Volume 1. We also got some videos to show y'all that we'll be premiering on 4-4. So we're working for the month of April. We're focused. All right. We got Third Eye Thursdays reboot, Melanin Monday reboot, Blurred Lines with Red and Blue. We got Build and Destroy coming back. Sacrilegious Sundays, Saturday Night Live. You know what I'm talking about? And Techno Tuesdays. Techno Tuesdays, all right? From Techno TV for Know the Ledger. So we working, you know what I mean? We not playing around. We're doing interviews. We're creating content. We are turning this platform into the streaming behemoth, the media empire it's always meant to be. You know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm talking about? And I want to give thanks to my Patreons. Y'all have everything to do with our upward mobility. Tap yourselves on the shoulders and whatnot. Y'all did real good by us, standing by us, holding it down. And we're going to continue to deliver top-tier product. We also, for the Patreons, we got some fire behind-the-scenes videos that we soon going to be dropping. The build-up to the album, the build-up to the project, the behind-the-scenes of the first album, listening. We also got some behind-the-scenes where we was with 19 Keys and them kicking it. We also got some behind-the-scenes at an event in Marietta where we were on our blur shit. We was running around, you know, running up on, like, the Star Troopers and the people from Star Trek and shit. You know, all of that nerd shit, you know what I mean? All of that cosplay stuff. So it was fun. Sometimes you gotta let your inner child just come out and whatnot. That's what this whole revolution in technology is. But what's really important that I want to leave y'all with is that I just finished a 4-week course.
Peace family, peace to you and yours, Brother Red Pill, aka Rich Bill, reporting live and direct. Yes, indeed, I am here to let the family know and to inform y'all, if you're not informed already, that YouTube terminated Know the Ledge Media. I'm getting a lot of inboxes, phone calls, text messages. They're like, yo, what happened to... Yeah, well, they made a move, and we didn't make it public like that because we were in litigation. We have a class action suit that we are going to pursue. We'll fill you in on that on a later date. But for now, we're in the process of removing all of our content off of YouTube because the algorithm is kind of going crazy right now. And we're building a standalone app, our own streaming platform. In the meantime, we're asking all of our supporters and our members to come over to Patreon. Patreon.com/RedPillar. This is a page I started in 2016. And we are committed to building up a membership. We are committed to building up a network. And it's going to start over there at Patreon. Me and Blue, we always have events. So Melanin Monday, Third Eye Thursdays, access there. We have a masterclass every month, at least two of them. You get it over there. We also have daily posts with technology news mostly, but it's also other news. We're going to bring on more contributors so we could just continuously use that as a repository.
That's right. Red Pillar. Patreon.com/RedPillar. Patreon.com/RedPillar. All right. That's another platform we're about to gentrify. You dig? Shout out to all of my KTLians over there. Patreon.com/RedPillar. It's free to sign up. So, brother Alkibalon, take us out with some good words, and we're going to tap back in with the family on another day.
Yeah, so, you know, first and foremost, you know, make sure you purchase, make sure you buy, make sure you grab your tickets. You know, again, this one is going to be, you know, a monumental build. You know, of course, we got myself, we got that, that's going to outweigh a lot of shit that's going on in the news media, you know, that we seem to be attracted to, a lot of us, you know. So, you know, this is well worth it, you know, and it, again, it sets the stage for, you know, post solar eclipse. So it's just a very, you know, important time to dive into a deeper level of occultic like information, you know, that give you some insight on what's going on in the world today and what's going to happen 10, 20, and even 30 years from now, you know. So with that being said, for the family, you know, I appreciate you, Red, of course. I appreciate you, Knowledge, of course, you know, and being on this platform, you know, and for the family, God Body Challenge, tap in.
Yeah.
April 6th, three to five days, solely coconut water. So with that being said, I'm going to land a plane there.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. Blood love. Yes, Star. Oh, yeah. How can I forget? This right here show, the show tonight is sponsored by the Mart 125th. All right, we got the new drip in the building. Check this out right here. We got Knowledge dripping in that new Kings County. That's that Make Gods Are Great Again, the back of that. You know what I'm talking about? This is our shutdown airports when I wear this. Then we got the KTL right here, the logo tee and whatnot with the arms decked out. Feel me? Then we got some pieces right here. Okay. Got to jump on the back, you know what I mean? So, you know, the merch is on deck, okay? All of this will be on deck. This will be rolled out on the site. This will be a part of the merch capsule when we roll out this new project, the 48 Pillars of Power, featuring the Twin Pillars, introducing our good brother 360, all right? Y'all about to get introduced to some to a new spitter. A new brother out here. You know, we introduced y'all to Cambada. You know what mm-hmm. I mean? We introduced y'all to Lizzie Jeff. We introduced y'all to a lot of people. We introduced y'all to Rain. Yeah. Through Red Summer. Right? They people was like, oh, who that? So the introduction continues. We're going to play our part of A&R. You know what I mean? We're going to play our part of MC. We rapping on this. We rapping like we got to pay the rent. You feel me? So, yeah, you're going to be very impressed. The rollout begins. When you see the advertising, make sure you share it. Make sure you get the word out there, because going back to the earlier conversation, everything in this new economy is predicated on you. If it now falls on the shoulders of the people that watch us, right? I'm not watching you. You watching me. I would watch you if I knew who you were, right? I don't have a problem with watching people. I'm a watcher, right? But I don't have, we don't have the opportunity to watch the thousands of people that watch us. We just privy to like a few of them. And those are great people. So imagine the kind of, imagine how my spirit is feeling so quote unquote unfulfilled. Nobody wonders about that.
Please let me work.
Like, we pour into mad people over the years, 20 years. Imagine how many lives we changed. But I never have the opportunity to come in contact with the people whose lives I'm helping. Shit. I would, you know what I mean? Imagine a doctor out here saving lives and he never gets to meet his patients. He's literally working through a through one of them glory holes. Right? He doing heart surgery through the glory hole. He don't get to see the people he helping. But he know he helping people. And he out here trying to get motion and get things going. He want to build his own hospital, but he never gets to see the people that he's helping. So that shit got to get fixed one day. Technology is going to be on the side of those who yearn to live in a world where they're able to to be in direct contact. They call direct to customer or direct to consumer. So that wall is soon going to fall, right? Especially with technology like VR and whatnot, these headsets and shit like that. When that wall falls, everything changes for the creative and for the talent and for people such as myself who are yearning to meet millions of y'all out there who've been introduced to me and I never met you as of yet. We didn't complete the cipher. So the cipher is incomplete on some Brooklyn shit. The cipher is incomplete. So Netmon is walking around in incomplete ciphers and whatnot. So for the people who have completed the cipher, y'all was able to walk so the rest of these people could run. So I want to say thank y'all for being good people. People who came into my life, y'all made me want to meet more people because y'all are good people. Y'all improved my life dramatically. Y'all helped boost that shit. So I'm just walking around in the world. I wake up every day grateful with mad gratitude because I'm like, yo, I'm on a hero's journey to meet thousands upon thousands of people who be like, that's Unk right there. So when I'm in the airport, I'm low-key when niggas is like, yo, Red, I'm like, somebody said something? Huh? I want all the shits. I'm with it. I ain't gonna lie. I ain't gonna lie, if I go through the airport and it's dry, I'm like, let me look at my analytics. You know what I'm saying? They must really been shadow banning me this month. I anticipate it. Because, you know, y'all some beautiful people.
Facts.
Shit.
Nah.
Y'all are real undervalued, underrated. They took the whole power out of the people by calling them followers, making you think that y'all wasn't as important as the people that you following.
Listen, man.
That's all, why motherfuckers is at home suicidal, got anxiety attacks, depression, weighing themselves against people on their phones, not realizing, nigga, you on the phone too.
Yeah.
You what are you talking about? You the same thing. You going through the same thing. The difference between maybe me and you is that I've embraced how to use the internet and you might not have.
Yeah, that's it.
That's it. It's perspective, once again. It's all vantage point. I know that I'm on the internet and this shit is a stage. You know what I'm saying? I know that this is a stage that you got to dance on. You not standing
be,
on.
Be conscious, man.
You
got to
be conscious of this shit.
Yeah.
It's like being on smack. You got the people that's battling. Then you got the NPCs on the stage that just be in the background like wallpaper. You know what I mean, the white
real
dude?
Shit.
Yeah, like, you just, yeah. White, you just, is you wallpaper or are you the nigga putting on the event of the night? Are you doing that? Are you shaking the fucking room,
yeah.
Bro?
Yeah.
Are you front and center?
Yeah.
Or are you the battle rapper that came with the nigga who's cooking
and you kind of like got to build your Tesla battery up and seeing that you living, you charged up, you living through surf.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I remember looking at Sue Surf Battle and he was charging mad Tesla cars on the side.
Hell yeah.
That all you niggas was plugged up to air surf. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? He was filling your tires up, changing your oil.
It's the energy, man.
It's the energy in the room. It's electric. I remember being at Sabie Lectures and he was charging my batteries.
Facts.
He was cooking.
Mm-hmm. Getting me hype.
Getting me hype.
Mm-hmm.
I remember being a little jit and Sabie be barefoot cooking.
Mm-hmm.
And you could see the wad of cash in his pocket, the print, big bank. You know what I mean? For selling herbs, I'm like, shit, me too. I was Mr. Me Too. I'm like, me too, you know? And then the day that I stood on the stage, not barefoot, because one of my feet, I couldn't be on OnlyFans as a foot model. Let's just say that. Unless niggas got some real crazy, if they got bite, if they got the ill, if they want to see a crushed toe, you know? But... yeah, man, this life that we live is very interesting. I wouldn't trade it for anything. You know, once again, like I say, I wake up highly favored, highly blessed. My son's birthday is tomorrow.
Happy birthday to Young King, Young Prince.
And I hate the internet is what it is, that I can't even share my little one with the internet, but Omari turns 4. This has been a journey that many people, even that rock with us, have been on. They saw me in the delivery room. You just had a young one the other day.
Yeah.
You feel me? So this who I do it for. Wisdom Bella, a.k.a. Pink Pill, the shit that she did over the years. And Amir, let's not even forget, Amir is the one who set this whole thing off. You know what I mean? He'd be on 2/5 in a baby carriage. You know what I'm saying? Holding it down. He been in more lectures than damn near 90% of the people in this movement.
Young Neo.
Yeah, Young Neo. So, you know, shout out to all of the parents that expose their progeny and their young ones to this information, unadulterated, non-apologetically. You know what I mean? You sat them in front of the curses and all of that. It didn't matter. You like, yo, you going to get it anyway. You going to hear this stuff anyway.
Facts.
Lord have mercy. God, hallelujah. And now you got these star seeds that are teaching you. They could ask you a question that could shake your whole reality. They could make sense of complex things or have the angelic energy of cherubims and other type of benevolent spirits to whereas they tame the beast in you. Yeah, thanks. Shout out to them.
Thanks.
But with that being said, we about to sign out, y'all.
Yeah, this was fun.
Yeah, this was real fun, man. Like I said, we are perfecting things. We're in a brand new studio. You know, if I could, I go live every day, you know what I mean, and give y'all some of this work as when we tighten up the screws and get this thing right, we will be giving y'all more content, more of a streaming experience. I'll keep it on, you know what I mean? We've been talking about bringing the God through with his own channel, you know, because the platforms are what's important. I need y'all to subscribe to this channel. I need you to share this channel. YouTube is one of the platforms that we stream on, but we're on Twitch, right? And we're also streaming on other channels that are outside the quote-unquote ecosystem that everybody is used to get censored. We're backing ourselves. We're on Rumble. We're on Twitch. We're streaming on IG sometimes. And we're on YouTube. Right now, this channel on YouTube, I need it to go up to 100,000. So we're going to be broadcasting sometimes for 3 hours straight. We're going to be uploading videos in the same vein that Vlad does his videos, where he does interviews and then he chops it up and whatnot and he segments it. We're going to be doing segmented content because right here is where we're going to be interviewing. Everybody comes through Atlanta. Everybody comes through. My network is crazy. You know what I mean? I don't know nobody with an illa Rolodex. So the more we get the support from the independent quote-unquote Patreons and the KT Aliens and anybody just comes through and you see the quality and you see that this is independent, you know what I mean? And you're an investor in greatness, and then you see all of these quote-unquote empires falling, and you know that the ones that are coming up are going to be the ones that stood on business for the past decade plus. Proof of work. Hold on. There's nothing that can stop that. It's called receipts. You know? It's called receipts. So all of the supporters over the years, and especially the ones who held it down when YouTube deleted the platform and whatnot, we are here rebuilding this thing on solid ground. Shout out to all of my Patreons. Platforms rule everything around me. Preem. You know what I'm talking about? We'll see you guys Third Eye Thursdays, but probably before that on a Techno Tuesday. You never know. All right? So, shout out to Blue Pillar. We'll be doing an interview with him as well. April 7th, y'all. Vote Your Culture on KTLUniversity.com. Or you could also find it on Eventbrite. Peace, love, and light. Stay dangerous. Let's play that commercial.
Armageddon in the Middle East in April 2024? And what does this have to do with Israel's war on Palestine's Gaza? On the 100-day anniversary of Israel's brutal assault on Gaza, Hamas spokesman Abu Ubaida released a video explaining the motivations behind the group's incursion into Israel on October 7th. Alongside Israel's continued occupation of Palestine, he also mentioned the bringing of red cows into the occupied Palestinian territories. Ubaida was referring to the plans of numerous right-wing Israeli groups who believe that a red cow must be sacrificed in order for the Jews to progress plans to demolish the Al-Aqsa Mosque and build the fabled Third Temple in its place. It might sound like a conspiracy theory, but hardliner Israeli group The Temple Institute have already purchased and imported 5 red Angus heifers from Texas at a cost of $500,000. They have been grazing in a kibbutz in the occupied West Bank since 2022, with reports that the sacrifice is planned to take place as early as April 2024. The sacrifice of the red heifer has its roots in the Torah and the Talmud, and it is believed that the ritual is necessary.